Did you know you can use drag and drop tools to customize the look and feel of your Salesforce? My name's Leanne Reimel. I'm a Senior Director of Admin Evangelism here at Salesforce, and I am here to show you how you can use App Builder to customize the page look and feel for your record pages, including custom and standard objects, as well as build brand new app pages. Let's take a look. We're going to start in our Sunshine Chocolates demo environment on the opportunity page. This is the standard opportunity page, and I want to update it to reflect how my colleagues work. Right now, we have the related lists on the right, the activity down the center, and we have tabs for details and chatter. I'm going to click the gear icon on the top right to edit page. This takes me to my App Builder page. This is the App Builder page for the opportunity. On the left, I have all of the components that are available to drag onto this page. This list of standard components can change based on what type of object you're looking at, and if I have App Exchange or custom components, they would be on the left. In the center, I have my canvas that shows me all of the components that are arranged to create my page. And in the right panel, I see the details about each component as I click through them. Now, what I want to do is get rid of this related panel on the right and bring it over to the center part of my page. So I'm going to delete that entire section. And now I'm going to go ahead and add a new tab. Tabs are a really powerful tool in App Builder. You can define the order of tabs, which tab you default to on a new page. And you can also add new tabs to store different components for your page. So I'm going to add a new tab to this tab component, and I'm going to select one of the pre-populated names for related. Perfect. So now I have this new related tab, but there's no component in it. That's because you have the control to determine what components you're going to bring into these different tab sections. So on the left, I'm going to find related list with my standard components. And when I bring that over, it populates all of those related list items. Now on the right, I can decide how I want this related list to look and feel by selecting maybe enhanced list, which gives us a little more power within the page with mass actions, resizing columns. I can determine how many records to display. And now I want to find something new to put into this column on the right. I'm going to select report chart so my users have a quick bird's eye view of everything going on with their account. So I bring in the component for report chart. Then in the right panel, I can determine which report I'd like to bring in and how to filter it. Once I've added that report chart and added filter by opportunity ID, let's determine when this should be visible. I'm going to use component visibility to ensure that this is only visible on the desktop and it's not available on the phone because that's what I think would most benefit my users. Now my opportunity page is updated. I've got my new tab in my center area here and I want to preview it for phone form. So on the top here, you can select if you want to view desktop or phone and I can now see all of those components and what it will look like on the phone. Note that the opportunity activity report does show here because even if you have filtered components, they still show on your preview so you're aware of everything that's on the page. Now that I've previewed this, I feel good about my updated opportunity page. I'm ready to save it and roll it out to users. So when I save, I'm prompted to activate because I've been building this page, but it's been creating a new page that's not yet activated for my users. On the activation panel, we can decide if we want to make this the org-wide default, if we want to assign it to a specific app, or if we want to get more granular and assign by record type or profiles. I'm going to make this my org-wide default for both desktop and phone and click save. Great. Now, when I go back to view my opportunity page, I'm going to see that updated page with just a few drag and drop components changed around. Now that we've updated one of our standard object pages with opportunity, let's take a look at what we can do with our custom object pages. Because just like there's different components available for different types of objects, there's also some different functionality that's available depending on what type of object you're working with. So I'm going to open up one of my project records, and project is a custom object that I've built here in my Sunshine Chocolates environment. And this is a pretty simple object here. I've got some fields, a related list, And I'm going to go back into that edit page for this page that'll take me to the App Builder page for projects. Notice that it did default back to phone because that's what I was just using. I'm going to go back to desktop preview. Great. Okay, so now we have all of our standard components that are available, but notice on the left, we also have a fields tab. And this allows us on custom objects to add field sections right in App Builder. So I'm going to drag into a new field section. And when I drag in that component on the right, I can do things like label it. I can determine if it has one or two columns. And just like all components, I can set my component visibility. So I'm going to call this customer details, and I'll keep it at two columns. Now, all of the fields that are available for this object are available here. So I can go ahead and expand that section, and I can drag over any of the fields that I'd like to work with to have segmented out in this specific section. Field sections are a really powerful way to control the look and feel of your page and right down to the granular level of what fields are displayed and when. And using that field visibility and component visibility tool gives you a lot of control as an admin to define what users see and when based on things like form factor, other values on the page, and profile. Okay, so I've got my field section created here. I'm also going to use App Builder to define some of these fields as required. So if I go into my project name field, I can use App Builder to even control the UI behavior of whether it's read-only, required, or none. Now let's focus on the top of the page. The highlights panel fields are controlled by the compact layout for this record type, but I also have a new option to upgrade to dynamic actions. I'm going to select Migrate. So this is going to inherit all of the actions from an existing page layout for my project's layout, which will enable dynamic actions for my page. Once I've done that, I have all of the actions available for that page layout now available right in App Builder. This means I can define which actions are available on this App Builder page right in App Builder. This is really impactful, particularly if you're using actions quite a bit in your org. This means that you can create different App Builder pages for different apps, different users, and you can control all of that right within App Builder. So I'm going to go ahead and update some actions here. We'll move new note up. Great. Now I'm going to save this and go back and take a look at my page. So we're back in our projects page, and I can see those new actions are reflected, and I also have this new field section that's nestled within my details component section. So this is just some of the ways that you can further fine-tune your pages with App Builder. Now we've done two record pages, let's go ahead and go to setup and create a brand new app page. I'm going to go to setup and find Lightning App Builder in the setup tree. This is where I can find all of the pages for any object or of any type, but I'm going to go ahead and say new page. When I create a new Lightning page, I have the option to make an app page, a home page, email page, embedded service page. We're going to go ahead and make a new app page. I'm going to name my app page Project Central because that's going to be the goal of this app page, to provide one home base for projects. Now I have all of these existing templates available to me, so I can preview them. On the far right, you can see what it'll look like on the mobile. And I'm going to select header in three regions. So now I've got a blank canvas in the middle, and I've got my standard components on the left. Let's first bring in a rich text component to add some additional information and maybe some notes for this page for everyone who's visiting it. I can format within rich text and make this a really welcoming experience page. Okay, so I've added my header here. Now I want to add more components to this page, to those three columns I see previewed. So on the left, I'm going to select report chart. So when I select report chart, any report that has a chart associated with it and is saved in a folder I have access to will be available here. So I've got all projects by start month. Now I'm also going to bring over a recent items standard component. And on recent items standard component, I can select which objects do I want to be looked at for this component. So I'm going to scroll all the way down for projects. And I can also determine how many records I want displayed. You can always select multiple objects to look at with recent items as well. And lastly, I'm going to add a list view component. So I have list views in my standard component. I drag it onto the page, and I'm going to have this list view also look at projects, and I can filter it by the list views I have access to or my list views. So I've got upcoming projects. Great. I'm going to say 6 records. Now it's time to save and activate this page. So when I activate the page, I can select the icon for it. I can select the name for this new app page. I can also select who has access to it. Is this something that's just for sysadmins or for users? Now it's time to add it to a Lightning Experience app. So this is all of my Lightning apps, and I can determine if I want to add this to one of my Lightning apps, which means it'll show up as one of the available tabs for those apps. And I also want to add it to my mobile navigation. So I'm going to add it to my mobile nav, and I can see it's Project Central down here. I can even drag it up closer to the top if it's something that's really important. App pages are really good mobile tools. I think they perform really well on mobile. They're very useful for mobile users to get everything in one place. And now when I go back, now that this is saved and activated, I can just go to App Launcher and search for that page and go check it out. So I'm going to open my Project Central app page, and I can see those 4 components I added and my chart, my list view. And this is a really useful central place for my users. So what we did there is customize the look and feel of a standard record page, a custom object record page, and even got started building a brand new page with App Builder. So I can't wait to see the pages that you build as you go build awesome experiences for your users in Salesforce. That's all for today. Thanks for joining. And make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you never miss a video like this. And visit admin.salesforce.com for more content that's specifically for you, our Salesforce admins. See you next time.